Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to the channel McNallie Money, home of all things stock, investment, and personal finance related. Now for today's video, we're going to be providing an update on CleanSpark. This is a company that I've been actively purchasing in my personal account. They just came out with very impressive May production results, and we have a lot to talk about in today's presentation. Now before we get into all that, please take a second, hit the like button, you guys. It's a big help to myself and the channel. If you're not already subscribed, McNallie Money, feel free to join. And let me know in the comment section below if you're currently holding shares of CleanSpark, how you think they stack up to some of the other miners, and what your thoughts are on this sector for the back half of 2023. Now, with that being said, let's get into today's video. Okay guys, so that's right. Today's video, we're going to be providing an update on CleanSpark Incorporated, trades on the NASDAQ in the United States under the ticker CLSK. This is one that I'm personally invested in, both in the form of shares and call option contracts, which I'm going to speak to towards the end of today's presentation. And as you can see, with the pullback in the price of Bitcoin, CleanSpark was down about 5.5%. This is as of close yesterday, Monday, June 5th. They gave up 23 cents on the session to close out just shy of $4 US. And as you can see in a 6-month graph, CleanSpark has really been on quite a run since the start of the year. So this was December 19th, trading at $1.78. They hit a high on April 18th of $5.03. And since then, they've been trading pretty well sideways in the $4 range. Now, for those of you who maybe missed our previous coverage or interviews with CleanSpark, I wanted to jump over to the corporate website, give you guys a quick refresher in terms of what this company is all about, and then we'll get into the main event, which is, of course, the May production results. Now, as you can see, the investor deck here has been updated as of May 10th, so fairly recently. CleanSpark has coined themselves as America's Bitcoin miner, which I think will be a critical differentiator down the road as we start to see more and more restrictions and governmental involvement in the crypto space. Our vision is to build the infrastructure of the future by being a top North American miner in terms of hash rate, sustainability, efficiency, and profitability. And we're actually going to look at some of these comparative metrics in relation to other miners towards the end of today's presentation. Their current daily Bitcoin production is averaging just about 17.5 Bitcoin per day, with a hash rate in the neighborhood of about 6.7 exahash per second, which represents approximately 2% of the global hash rate. Now, what's really exciting is by the end of this year, CleanSpark is targeting 16 exahash per second in terms of capacity, which really is going to propel them into the upper echelons in terms of overall mining capabilities compared to their peers. And again, we're going to look at that towards the end of the video. Now, the May production result came out on June 2nd. You can see they released their 2023 Bitcoin mining update, very similar to what we see with a lot of the miners. This was one of the first ones to actually come out. They grew their Bitcoin holdings by 44%. So I'm going to circle back on that because this was a key pivotal point in my mind for CleanSpark and this company moving forward, is they're now starting to accumulate more Bitcoin than they need to sell each month to fund their operations. And you can see the actual number of Bitcoin mined in month was 609, which represents a 16% increase in the month of May. Now, Zach Bradford, who's the CEO of CleanSpark, goes on to say, "We achieved a significant milestone during the month of May. Not only do we continue to increase the amount of Bitcoin in our treasury, which again is super important for me as an investor, but we also surpassed $100 million in revenue for the fiscal year to date." Now, in addition to that, he says the amount of Bitcoin we mined this month exceeded our expectations, largely due to the increase in operational efficiency and a brief, albeit significant, increase in the transaction fees. So for about 5 days in May, fees were elevated because of increased interest in ordinals on the blockchain. And at its peak, our Bitcoin production jumped to nearly 30 Bitcoins in a single day, which is almost double the normal daily average of about 18 Bitcoin. Now, since then, the transaction fees have normalized, so that's returned to the mean. But this was a key month for the Bitcoin miners because, again, we saw a massive increase in the number of transactions. And obviously, for the miners who verify those transactions, that was extremely favorable. And a quick side note here, an ordinal is a piece of information that's actually written into the blockchain and referenced by a unique address and also held in the blockchain infrastructure. So a quick call out and definition for those of you who maybe haven't heard this term before. Now, if we continue to scroll through the article into the actual numbers, you can see that super impressive May production number of 609 Bitcoin. So that gives them a calendar year to date Bitcoin total of 3,004. And as I mentioned earlier, they actually increased the number of Bitcoin in their reserve, which is now sitting just north of 451 Bitcoin. So in the month of May, they converted 471 Bitcoin, which represents approximately 77% of the 609 Bitcoin that were mined. Or said another way, 138 Bitcoin were deposited into the company's reserve in the month of May alone. And as you can see, with production numbers in excess of 600 Bitcoin per month, it won't take long at all for CleanSpark to really build that reserve in a meaningful way. Now, in terms of their fleet, they have about 67,000 of the latest generation Bitcoin miners currently in operation. Their hash rate, again, sitting at about 6.7 exahash. And another thing I wanted to call out here, you guys, is it's important to note the average selling price of each Bitcoin was about $27,400 in the month of May. That generated net proceeds of about $12.9 million. So a lot of people, when they think about the price of Bitcoin, they say, oh my God, if the price of Bitcoin were to double, a lot of these stocks would double. You got to think about it in terms of an actual business here, you guys, with input costs in the neighborhood of about $15,000, $20,000, $25,000. For a cash cost all in on each Bitcoin. Companies really only need the actual price of Bitcoin to increase a few thousand dollars to make a meaningful impact on their actual profit. So although the price of Bitcoin is trading, say, at $27,000, let's assume, for example, that the all-in cost is about $20,000. We only need the price of Bitcoin to increase by $7,400, which would put it in the neighborhood of about $35,000 for the actual profit that a lot of these miners are seeing to essentially double. And that's what really gets me excited about the numbers we're starting to see, you guys, is a lot of the costs are sunk costs with equipment, with power, with overhead. So although we may see the network difficulty increase slightly if we see a big run in the price of Bitcoin, the actual cost it takes to mine these Bitcoin is going to stay relatively consistent, and we're going to see a massive impact to the gross revenue and to the net profit of a lot of these organizations. And I've actually done some Excel modeling where I predict out the price of Bitcoin at various different milestones and the impact it has to, again, revenue and overall profit to these miners is absolutely crazy as you start to move up into the $40,000, $50,000, $60,000, $70,000 Bitcoin. Now, the other piece of news that has just recently come out in relation to CleanSpark talks about a big purchase of miners, 12,500 Antminer S19 XP units that they just picked up for about $40 million. This one's extremely impressive in terms of the price that they actually paid for these computing units. You can see this is in part of getting them to that 16 exahash per second goal by year end. But if you actually look at the purchase agreement here, they paid about $23 per terahash, which is actually below the current average market price for these units. So as we've talked about in previous videos, the efficiency component is starting to become crucial for a lot of these crypto mining companies, and the S19 XPs have a power efficiency rating of 21.5 joules per terahash, which is industry leading. And in total, these 12,500 units represent about 1.76 exahash per second that again will flow into that 16 exahash per second goal. Now, in terms of the delivery timeline, they're getting approximately half of these in June and the other half in August. And you can see this purchase is actually the latest in a series of discounted machine purchases. We talked to Matt Schultz about this in our last CleanSpark interview. The bear market here, you guys, has really put a lot of pressure on companies that purchase these rigs at inflated prices. And as a result, companies like CleanSpark that have a great balance sheet are now able to acquire these rigs or mining units at a fraction of the retail price that they were going for just a few quarters ago. And you can see this CFO Gary calls out specifically that they're looking at efficient miners in anticipation of next year's halving event, because at that point, the reward these miners are going to get for each block that's solved is going to be cut in half. So efficiency is going to be paramount at that point in time. So as an investor, this was great to see that not only are they making progress towards that committed 16 exahash per second target, but they're also making progress in a financially responsible way with the latest, greatest, and most efficient machines. Now, this is where it gets super interesting and exciting for me as an investor in CleanSpark. Now, earlier in the presentation, I promised that we're going to look at a comparative slide. This is out of the CleanSpark investor presentation that came out in May. You can see that 6.7 exahash per second number where they finished the month of May. Third only to Mara and Riot here, who are sitting north of 10 exahash per second each. In terms of the Bitcoin mined, this was for the month of April, so they mined 524 Bitcoin. In the month of May, as we just saw, they mined 609. And again, a big reason for that month over month jump was the network activity that we saw and the amount of transactions that were pending in the month of May. Now you can see Riot came in at 639 Bitcoin compared to Mara at 702 in the month of April. And if we actually pull up Riot's May production numbers, you can see they came in at 676 in the month of May, meaning they beat CleanSpark by 67 Bitcoin, or about 10%. Now keep in mind, Riot has a market cap in excess of $2 billion and is widely considered to be one of the heavyweights in the crypto mining space. So it's great to see that CleanSpark is really following suit with some of those bigger players. And in terms of market cap, only represents a fraction of what we see from Riot. Now keep in mind, Riot has a huge Bitcoin reserve, I think in excess of about 7,000 Bitcoin. But as we're starting to see from CleanSpark, each and every month they're adding to that reserve as the price of Bitcoin increases, and they're able to actually siphon off a bigger percentage of their in-month mining activity to go towards that reserve. Now the biggest metric I wanted to point out here is the efficiency metric. So this is called the Bitcoin hash rate realization rate, and this landed just shy of 97% for CleanSpark, which represents second best in the industry only to Hive, which had a 99.71% efficiency. And again, this is for the month of April. So the summary here, you guys, is regardless of which metric you're looking at, overall hash rate, Bitcoin mined, market cap, or efficiency, CleanSpark is really in the upper echelons of this community or this sector, and I'm feeling really good about my investment in this company. Now with that being said, and to close out today's video, I wanted to show you guys my most recent trades as it relates to CleanSpark. I have switched up my strategy a little bit, and as you can see, my last three trades on this ticker were all in the form of call options dated for January 17th of 2025. So this is in my private options account. You can see I've been buying a number of calls in the crypto mining space, so Bitfarms, Hut 8, CleanSpark, and I actually bought a couple call options on Riot as well in another one of my accounts. But this strike and expiration looks extremely promising to me. So this is a $2.50 call dated again for January 17th of 2025. So it gives you the full duration of 2024 when we're expecting to see that big next halving event. And at a strike price of $2.50 with an average buy price in the neighborhood of about $2.50 or $2.60, I essentially need CleanSpark to be trading above $5 US by January of 2025 to be in the money on these call options. And I currently have 7 contracts that are dated with the same expiration. So given the fact that CleanSpark is currently trading about $4 US and Bitcoin prices are currently trading about a third of their all-time high, I definitely don't think it's a stretch to expect shares of CleanSpark could be trading in the $10, $15, $20, or $25 range if we see a big run in the price of Bitcoin and we start to surpass some of those all-time highs we've seen in the past, as a lot of experts are really expecting in anticipation of next year's halving event. And you'll actually see with a lot of these option contracts, with the exception of Bitfarms, I've gone for that same expiration date, January 17th of 2025, because I really think that thesis makes sense. And I think 2024 is gonna be a pivotal year for cryptocurrency and for the price of Bitcoin. So with that being said, you guys, I'd be super curious to hear your thoughts on CleanSpark in the comment section below. What did you think about their May production results? And are you currently holding shares of this company? If you're still watching the video at this point, hopefully you found some value. So make sure you hit the like button. And if you're not currently subscribed to the channel, McNallie Money, feel free to join. We'd love to have you as part of the community. That's all for now. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.